At least 70 Palestinians killed, while more than 200 were wounded in Israel's latest assault on Khan Yunis in southern Gaza. Israel sent tanks back and launched airstrikes into the area, citing renewed attacks by the Hamas militants, giving little time for civilians to evacuate. Around 400,000 Palestinians were living in the targeted area, which was initially designated as a safe zone. The death toll in Israel's retaliatory offensive against Hamas has reached more than 39,000. Over in Ethiopia, at least 50 were killed in a landslide. Authorities say the death toll rose after rescuers got trapped while searching for victims. Women, children, and local police were among the fatalities. The landslides were triggered by days of heavy rains over a mountainous area of South Ethiopia. Videos from the scene showed rescuers digging with their bare hands. Heading now to the U.S. as Vice President Kamala Harris seeks to reset the Democratic campaign. Harris made a stop in Washington, D.C. for her first public appearance since launching her White House bid. There, she praised U.S. President Joe Biden's leadership and the work he's done in the past 3 years.
Joe Biden's legacy of accomplishment over the past 3 years is unmatched in modern history. In one term, he has already, yes, you may clap. In one term, he has already surpassed the legacy of most presidents who have served 2 terms in office. And I first came to know President Biden through his son, Beau. We worked together as attorneys general in our states. And back then, Beau would often tell me stories about his dad, his honesty, his integrity, his commitment to his faith and his family, his big heart, and his love, deep love of our country. And I am firsthand witness that every day our President Joe Biden fights for the American people, and we are deeply, deeply grateful for his service to our nation.
Biden's departure was the latest shock to a White House race that included the near assassination of Donald Trump during a campaign stop in Pennsylvania. U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris is making strides in what U.S. President Joe Biden failed to do: unite Democrats in the race for the White House. Her latest endorsement coming from former House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. Pelosi played a leading role in persuading Biden to step aside as concerns over his ability to beat Donald Trump grew after their debate last month. Democratic Senator Dick Durbin also giving his seal of approval to Harris as he welcomed Biden's decision to abandon his re-election bid.
The announcement yesterday by President Biden came as a surprise to many. This has been building for some period of time. I want to salute him. It is an extraordinary decision for someone who has a lifetime in public service to step aside for the good of the country and the good of his party. He made that decision yesterday. I'm sure it wasn't an easy one for him. 106 days, if we're going to wage a successful campaign against Donald Trump, we've got to get our act together. So I'm hoping that more Democrats will step forward to support her nomination. And we'll get underway in just a few weeks with the convention.
The vice president's campaign said it raised $81 million in just 24 hours since Harris announced her White House bid. The massive haul represents the largest 24-hour sum reported by either side in the 2024 campaign. Over now to Capitol Hill as House Republicans and Democrats take a rare united stand. Both sides of the political aisle are calling on U.S. Secret Service Director Kimberly Cheadle to resign over security failures that led to the assassination attempt on Donald Trump in Pennsylvania last week. James Comer, the Republican chairperson of the House Oversight Committee, and top Democrat Jamie Raskin, who are bitterly divided on most issues, called on Cheadle to step down. But she repeatedly rebuffed the resignation calls.
It is my firm belief, Director Cheadle, that you should resign. However, in complete defiance, Director Cheadle has maintained she will not tender her resignation.
I will be joining the chairman in calling for the resignation of the director, just because I think that this relationship is irretrievable at this point, and I think that the director has lost the confidence of Congress at a very urgent and tender moment in the history of the country, and we need to very quickly move beyond this.
Despite her refusal to step down, Cheadle admitted she and the agency failed to do their job.
The Secret Service's solemn mission is to protect our nation's leaders. On July 13th, we failed. As a director of the United States Secret Service, I take full responsibility for any security lapse of our agency. We are fully cooperating with ongoing investigations. We must learn what happened, and I will move heaven and earth to ensure that an incident like July 13th does not happen again.